HDR, IR, verification. So it's a document posted for the received goods. What is GR? It's a document posted for the received goods. Okay. So we have to discuss, right? Once we have the requirement, we will write a PR, we will take up for next course merging team, they will do RFQ process. Once we have got selected, so they will create a PO. Next, once we have the PO to vendor, vendor will deliver the goods. In a company, along with the invoice. Sometimes you can send only goods, sometimes along with the invoice you can deliver the goods. So in a company, every day you will produce so many materials from so many vendors. Okay, now. So after receiving each PO's goods, so you have to create a document. Suppose you are working in equity department, once after receiving a PO's goods, so you have to maintain document, like which PO goods it is. Okay. While delivering goods, so after creating a PO, you will get a PO number, right? By mentioning the same PO number, vendor will send the goods and invoice. Understanding. Once goods are to the company, they will check it, which PO goods it is. Okay. So they will check same PO number in, by displaying in our ERP software. Okay. So as per the PO, suppose you place the order for 100 display, 100 quantity of display, material is display, display delivered or not, how much quantity, as per the PO it delivered or not. And in PO you mentioned a plant is, for which plant we place the order, for the same plant we have delivered goods or not. Okay. Sometimes we are doing regularly, sometimes by mistake vendor can deliver goods. So suppose if you place the order for plant 1, so vendor can by mistake you can deliver plant 2. Okay, you got to check it. Next, so to which vendor we place the order, from the same vendor we receive goods or not. Everything you have to check it. There is no issue with the goods, everything is fine. So they will move the goods to particular inventory and store, they will store it properly. For that, after that, they will create a goods list. What are the information you have to maintain while generating goods list? You have to mention PO number first. This PO goods will receive. And so ordered quantity this much, received quantity this much, and on what date we receive. Next, from which vendor you receive. Next, for which plant, for our store location we receive. These are the details we have to maintain. Okay, now. For each PO's received goods, you have to maintain document like this, one by one. In a company, they will receive so many goods for so many people. Okay, by maintaining all this information, so they will maintain. Suppose you place an order for 100 quantity, so by through some shipping problem, order delivered only 80 quantity. Then, when creating GR, so you have to mention PO number. Order quantity 100, received quantity 80, like that. Okay. That is the document posted for the received goods. For each PO's goods, one by one, you have to maintain proper document like that. Okay. Next, what they will do, what are the document you, otherwise, what are the general slip? Okay, now. So, unit department they created. By converting the slip into a soft copy, by attaching the soft copy to your PO number, they will send list of POs to you. Suppose you are working in GR department. So suppose you are working in PR to PO department, how they will send list of approved PRs to you for creating a PR. Sorry, for creating a PO for those PRs. Same another, which are the POs goods they received and whatever the document they generated generally. By attaching that document to your PO number, they will send list of POs to you for posting a GR. Okay now. So with respect to that, so you have to post a GR with respect to PO. So here we have a T code, MIGO. By using the code MIGO, we can post a GR. This is the T code you have to use for posting a GR with respect to PO. Okay. So once after entering PO number here, all the details except price condition, material, quantity, store location, plant, all the details get copied from the PO. And once after all the details got copied from the PO, you got to check it. Okay, you have to check the slip, whatever the quantity they mentioned. Suppose as per the PO they received all the quantity, as per the PO you can post it. Otherwise, so you have to edit the quantity, left how much quantity they received, that much quantity only you have to post a GR. Understanding? Okay. So, once after posting GR, what are the things get updated in our system? So, these are the things are very important. After posting GR, first material stock, inventory stock get updated for a particular material. For which material we posted a GR? So that material stock get updated in our inventory, in our plant and store location level. So after putting GR, stock got updated properly. If you want to see that stock, go to T code MAPE, where you can see the how many available stock we have for each material under the particular plant and store location level. Next. So in PO, for each line item, Suppose we register PO for multiple item, vendor delivered all the goods, we posted GR for all the item. For each item system separately updates purchase order history tab. Purchase order history tab. So here you can see how much quantity GR we posted and how much quantity IR also, after posting IR also, that things also get updated under the purchase order history tab. Next, in PO, in delivery tab, so you might have seen, so delivery complete indicator checkbox is there. Delivery complete indicator checkbox is there. So suppose you press the order for 100 quantity for a particular item, you posted a GR all the 100 quantity because vendor delivered all the 100 quantity. There is no pending quantity. So then the checkbox get activated like this. Okay. So it indicates means what? So for a single item, there is no pending quantity, we received all the quantity. Next. So after posting GR, so once after creating a PR, PO, RF code, you get a document number. Once after posting GR, once after posting GR, system automatically generates two documents. First one is material document, second one is accounting document. In account, in material document, we can see like which material we received, how much quantity, plant, store location under. In account document, system automatically calculates in backend and updates the things. Like this much cost of raw materials we procured, after posting IR, this much cost we have to pay with respect to material. Okay, now, only for material. Okay, so here we have so many accounts for so many so many types of accounts here for updating a for different purpose, they will use different JR accounts. Okay, so once after posting a JR one is standard, two accounts we have. First one is BSX, second one is WRX. BSX for posting a inventory account. So here inventory account get debited and JR account get credited. So BSS means inventory account means this much cost of material we procured today our inventory. Okay now. So next one, this one is inventory account. Second one is this one is GRIR clearing account. This one get credited. This means this much amount you have to pay. Suppose we procure 10,000 material, cost of material. So this account get credited. Sorry, debited, this account get credited. It means what? After posting IR, this much amount you have to clear to vendor for the material. And so in inventory account, this much cost of raw materials we procure to our inventory. Like that it get updated. Understood. So next in material we have two fields in accounting, you can see. So total value and total stock. Total value and total stock get updated. Suppose it is a purchasing material, you use the material price, you use the price control of moving average price, then total value also get updated. Suppose you use only standard price. Standard is a finished goods, right? We are going to save. Okay, if you post here for that, only total stock and price difference get updated. So once after posting GR, all these things get updated. Okay, so you have to know. Next, here we will use majorly movement types. Movement types are very important here. So movement type create a movement type. When it comes to GR, we can do so many activities by using same decode, but where we have to use different movement type. Movement type decides where goods is going, which action you are doing, so with that material. So
in this case we order 100 quantity, the vendor managed to send only 80 quantity. So in that case how we can do?
So they would be able generating your inventory department while creating the slip, they would mention only 80 quantity. Already is 100, received is 80. So while posting GR in our year EFA software, so once you've done the PO, all the details get copied from the PO. 100 quantity only get copied. So next you have to edit it, 100 to 80. You have to post GR only for 80 quantity. Once after receiving the inventory quantity, you have to post more than GR for the inventory. Next year we will use movement type 101 for posting a GR. So we should have goods, as per the PO vendor delivered a goods, there is no issue with the goods, goods are fine. Then we can post GR by using movement type 101. Suppose while generating the document in our EFA software, by mistake we entered a wrong store location. Otherwise, whatever the goods we received, whatever the GR we posted for a particular PO, for those PO's goods, we did not receive. Okay, now. So by mistake we posted. Okay, now. It could be any reason. If you want to cancel, we can cancel. Cancellation of GR. Next, 103. So sometimes, so vendor can deliver the goods without mentioning PO number.
Sir, cancellation means the goods will be sent back to vendor.
No, in our year software only, so whatever document we generated and whatever the update we maintained, all the software we can cancel. Okay, we will not return to vendor. That is our mistake. While in the general DR, if my mistake you wanted a wrong document date, otherwise wrong store location, if you want to cancel, we can cancel it. So 103 means, so GR block stock. So GR block stock means, sometimes vendor can deliver the goods without mentioning PO number. So we can write down GR block stock. Okay, so our inventory department there is good goods. Sometimes vendor can send without mentioning PO number, without mentioning goods details, it could be part number, serial number, or anything, or manufacturing part number, like anything. So until we get a proper detailed information about the goods, so we can move the goods to particular. So we don't want to use those goods, but you have to store it, but you don't want to allow to use. Okay, now then we will move the goods to GR block stock. Then we cannot use the goods. Then after moving the, suppose you are working in the inventory department, you should have goods like that, you move to goods to GR block stock. After that, so the inventory department persons by sharing their PO number to then they will check it. So for this purchasing, purchase order, who is the purchasing, which is the purchasing group. So that they will inform. Okay, so they will check it into a purchase order number. So which purchasing group is responsible for handling this PO? Okay, whatever the PO's goods we received like that. So by sharing your PO number to that particular purchasing group, they will ask. So for this PO, so you are the responsible. We received a good, there is no issue with the goods, but without mentioning part number, serial number, or PO number, under delivered a goods. Okay, then so they will contact the vendor, they will get the goods details, it could be any details. After getting the proper details, they will release. Okay, from the block stock to normal stock. For releasing, we have a movement type 105. Release GR block stock. And in some cases, we received a goods. So while receiving a goods, we did not observe properly. But while consumption, so while using our production activity, so out of 100 quantity, we found 20 damaged goods. Okay, now. So if you want to return 20 damaged goods to vendor, we have a movement type 122. Return to vendor. Totally in SAP MM, we have 708 movement types are there. So at least you have to know which are all the regularly used movement types. Okay, so in some other process, some other movement types we have, we can discuss. So who is your role while working in the GR department? So which are all the POs they received, goods they received, so whatever the document they generated by attaching a soft copy of the document to your PO, they will send list of POs to you. Okay. So with respect to the PO number, you have to post GR, posting G code MIGO, and while posting GR as per the PO, you have to check it. As per the PO, they received a goods or not by checking with the scheme. Okay. So while creating PR to PO, so how they can attach quotation details and attachment keys, same manner here. So post GR, posting G code, MIGO. Go on create first one of PO. So for this PR, we already created a PO, that's why Pandi not copied here. Okay. So I am simply creating one PO. So why did not ask for the first item to meet a press condition? For the first item, we made an infer record. From the infer record, all the press condition got copied automatically. See, so simply I created one PO. So just imagine for this PO, we should have goods. Okay, now you have to post GR for this PO. your number. Just display this PO. See, same like, while converting one PR into PO, how we will display the PR or validity, same like, so when for the interval to this PO, you are going to post GR, that PO number you have to display. Photo input again, and display the PO. So here is simply creating one PO, but in real time, without releasing PO, without releasing PR, we cannot even have. This is the display of PR. Like that, sorry, PO. Like you don't display it. See that. So once after posting GR, for each line item we will get a purchase order data here. Where we can see how much quantity we posted GR and GR document. And if GR, if you post GR for all the quantity, so system automatically activate this checkbox. Okay. Next, in another level, instead of service showing, so including both the items, you place the order for 3000 quantity. After receiving the goods, after posting a GR, how much quantity we received, that much quantity is interpreted here. If you have a pending quantity, then it shows this much quantity is pending. Understand? Next, go to GR screen. So this is the user graph there. Okay, enter one more time. Go to MIG. See, this is the Excel screen of MIGO. So here you have to select. So goods distributed. So with, see what are the activities we discussed now. All the activities we can do here. So next, if you want to do GR, so now we are going to goods distributed. Choose that option here. With respect to which document? With respect to PU. So enter the plan. So this is our plan. So here you have to use the movement type 101. Suppose if you have any issue with the goods, then you can use the movement type 103. There is no issue with the goods, then you can use the movement type 101 here. So these three things you have to check. Now we are going to do GR with respect to PO for this plan. So movement type is 101. So that's it. Nothing to do here. For with respect to which PO we are going to post GR, that PO number here you have to enter. Okay. What is the PO number? So 173, which is the PO number, just copy here. Enter. Except price condition, material, quantity, plan, show location, vendor, all those things got copied here. See? So next you have to check it. Material, quantity, plan and show locations, purchase order. If you maintain show location in PO, show location also get copied here. So here I am going to enter one show location. First plan to have one show location. Next, purchase order. So partner, vendor name, each and every day is printing up and not what check it. See here you have to know what if you document it whenever inventory department they receive the goods. So today you are going to post GR in our EFT software. So if you want to know when it is documented, so you can go to here. Same like PR here also you have an attachment issue because it shows whatever the slip they generated after posting GR. Whereas we can see if you click on this attachment it shows for this particular PO whatever the slip generated. Where you can see PO number, so they would mention like this much quantity we ordered, this much quantity we received. Okay, now suppose they mention this much quantity we received as per the PO, then we can, as per the PO, we can post a GR. Otherwise, they mention like order quantity is 100, received quantity is 900, we are edit the quantity. Okay, as per the PO, they received all the quantity, they would have mentioned same quantity in the slip also. Okay, now so if they received same as per the PO, so without changing anything here. So yeah, only PO all the copy correctly or not, you want to check it and you have to post a GR. We are going to post GR as per the PO, you have to check with the slip. Same quantity they mentioned, like as a received quantity, we can post a GR as per the PO. Understood. Next, sometimes a matter can send along with the goods, you can send invoice also. You can enter for our reference, you can enter invoice number here. So we'll use that number while posting the item. See here. So this is the first line of details. This is the second line of details. If we click on that second item, we can see each line of details. And here we have to checking all the details. Nothing to do here. Once you enter your number, all the details get copied from the PO and click on the attachment and compare with the slip. Everything is okay. You have to post it. That's it. That is your job. Next, everything is okay. Click on item okay. So suppose out of these two line item, they delivered only first line item. Once you enter your number, all the items get copied here. So they received only first line item. Then you have to activate item okay checkbox for only first line item. So now we activate for the second line item. Remove the item okay for second line item. Activate item okay for the first line item. Suppose your PO you have a 10 line item. If you by mistake if you activate only one line item, that line item only get posted. Understood? So you have to carefully activate all the checkbox. Click on item okay. Now we should both the random and we should add the random. Understanding? So now check it. If you have any error, it shows. While posting GR0 system, I think you can get 3 to 4 errors. Okay. Task enter show location. I think we missed the show location for the second line item. Because they made it as a mandatory field. Check it now. See, after posting DR, so in purchase data get updated here, delivery commission ticket check activate here. Okay, and one more thing. So in middle master, you can see the total stock and total value. In for this material, we already posted a GR, we have some quality. After posting GR, how things get updated, you can see. Yes, second line item only. Go to 703. In accounting view, we can see the total stock and total value. I'm directly going to choose accounting view. So in accounting view, see, we use the standard price. This is a finished products only stock get updated here. So now we have a zero stock. After posting for this line item, we create a order for 2000. If you push GR for 2020, so you can get here 2020 stock here. Next, if you want to check like how many available stock we have in our plant store location level for this particular material. So we have a T code MMB. What MMB? You have to observe after posting GR how things get updated here. This is the material on plant store location, just execute it. Enter the material. Enter plant and show location under which plant, which show location we are going to check and execute. It shows how many available stock we have. See, we have a zero stock up here. Okay. After posting GR, we will get stock here. So, check it. Post it. Like one by one, you have posted GR. Document is posted now. Now go and check the see material document is generated. Later we can see with respect to this which is the accounting document. Now go and see stock volume. See how stock got updated here. Sometimes it takes time to save in backend. See, so we posted GR for I am checking only for second line item. Okay, stock got updated here. Next, go and just refresh your PO. Sometimes it takes time to show stock in backend. Just refresh your PO. C see how we can get done. See, delivery completed, check box activated, and purchase order sheet are updated. So where you can see, so how much quantity you purchased here. Now you're showing first item, this is like second item, so second item details. So you purchased here for all the quantity, that's why this checkbox automatically activated. If you left one quantity, so this checkbox will not get activated. Next, go to delivery tab, order tab. See, initially it was showing order and scheduled delivery. Now it's showing delivery because you purchased here for all the quantity. So same like open PR and closed PR, here also we have a concept open PO and closed PO. For a particular PO delivery is completed, so we can call it is a closed PO. For a particular PO delivery is not completed, you can call to open PO. Next, see here. So if you want to check, suppose you register a PO for all the line items, so many line items, if you want to check this PO is closed or not, we can directly come to status tab where you can check how much quantity ordered is for delivered, same, it means it is a closed PO. If you want to check particular item is closed or not, then you can go to delivery tab, you can check. So checkbox updated or not. Otherwise, you can go to purchase order sheet tab where you can see. As per the order quantity, they posted a JR or not. Understood. One by one, you have selected. Check it. Which item you have printing quantity, further select item, you have to follow up the matter and you will go to the goods delivery online. Understanding? Next, go on checking material master also. So once again, refresh your material. See, here also saga updated. So if you use first price control B, here you can get a value also. Okay, for the purchasing product. So if you use standard price, think as a finished product. Our system generates two documents here. First one is material document, second one is accounting document. So if you want to see what is the accounting document with respect to this material document, go here, choose the option display. Okay. Enter the material document, choose the material document option here, enter the material document which you want to see. It shows same information. Okay. So with respect to this, which is the accounting document, go to document information, click on FI documents. For each item, two accounts will be dependent here. Go to double content, this double document. Here you can see these two are first line item, these two are second line item. So inventory account, this is the JRI clearance account. This amount is uploaded with a minus. Here, minus means here is reverse, credit. Okay now. So plus means debit. So it means this much cost of raw materials will be put to our inventory. For the first line item. This is second line item. So this much cost you have to pay after posting IR. Okay. Suppose like you can post here and get the update. Suppose when posting it here, by mistake you entered a wrong document date, otherwise by mistake you entered a wrong store location. Okay, for whatever the PO we received and for whatever GR you posted for a particular PO, so you are not receiving goods, but you posted a GR. Goods is not received, but instead you posted a GR. Okay, never here to software. So if you want to cancel, it could be any reason if you want to cancel. So very simple, choose the option cancellation here. Enter the which material document you want to cancel. So here you can see the latest material documents, you can search here. Which material document you can cancel, you can cancel it. Okay, no one currently we can post this one only, enter it. So if you choose cancellation here, system only takes automatically moment type 1 or 2. They configure like that. And so here also, you can enter okay for both the line item because you are going to calculate both the cancel both the line item. Suppose you posted GR for 2 line item, this will only first line item. Then we can enter it, only you can cancel the first second line item. Check it, post it. Automatically start getting deleted in our system. What's up, cancelling? So, view automatically get open. Delivery completely indicate automatically get deactivated. Okay. See? Understood. So, next we can post GR, voicing. So, what are the details we missed? Otherwise, so after receiving goods, we can push it here. So we cannot post a GR multiple times for the same PO. Suppose we posted a GR for other quantity. Suppose we posted a GR for partial quantity, then we can post it. Understood? The data okay for both the data and enter store location. So we check it and post it, we can directly post it. Suppose dashboard execute. Like you can push GR and you can calculate GR. Suppose for a particular PO, received a goods without mentioning part number, serial number, and delivered a goods. Until you get that material, you have to put the goods to block structure. GR block structure. How to move? So here you have to change the movement type 101 to 103. Because you have issued these goods, until you get a classification, you have to put the goods to block structure. That is the movement type 103. So just look to which PO goods received. So I am using same PO number because we cancelled it. Now, you have to move this goods to block structure because without mentioning serial number, part number, or delivered goods. There is no difference in the details, each and every details are same, but you have to use the movement type proceed. We can enter OK, automatically post it to GR block structure. So if you post a GR, target update, by the movement type 101, target update under the unrestricted use tab. Unrestricted means there is no restriction for you because goods are fine. If you have issued the goods, then you have to move the goods to here, GR block structure. System doesn't allow to consume the goods. There is no difference in details. Enter the PO number, all the details will copy it. Use the movement type 103, that's it. Target update. Check it. Post it. Now we can go and refresh the stock. We can see stock under the GR block structure. So then unit people will inform the purchasing team or group, they will cover the details from the vendor, then they will inform to purchasing group or unit department. Then finally they have to release it. Okay. If you release goods from the block stock, you can get a stock update under the unrestricted stock. How to release? So you have an option here by using movement type 105. That's it. Choose the option. Here you have an option. Release GR block stock. So which document number you put as a block document that enter the document, enter it. All the details will be copied here. So we can item OK for both the item. Check it, post it. System. So for this, we have to maintain low location. For not one, so they maintain as a store location as a mandatory field. For not one moment. Check it. Now we can see stock under the unrestricted use stock. Refresh here, stock moving. Understood. Next, out of 2000 quantity, so while receiving goods, our unit department did not observe properly through bath they received. So while consuming a goods, so out of 2000 quantity, so we found 20 under damaged goods. Okay, you return under damaged goods to vendor. Sometimes, like while shipping, like it can happen. Okay, so then how to return the goods to vendor? Return delivery. Enter the measurement document if you want to use. Enter it. System will automatically take the movement API 122. Okay. Suppose out of and two line item, only when the first item is away, so we found under damaged goods. Okay now. So then how we can do? So nothing to do here. We have documented the item okay check box for the first line item only. So out of 120, we have found. So now we are checking second item. Okay, go on doing second item. Out of 2020, form under damaged goods. So in first item, everything is fine. Second item. Okay. If you have to data okay for second item also gets written. Understand? You have to do carefully. Next, go to where tab, why we are getting the goods to vendor? We have to do the reason here. It could be a damage, poor quality, or incomplete, anything we can give here. So, damage, we can do that. Check it. Okay, we upload second item also, first item also, just remove this because we are not going to return second item, sorry, first item. We are going to return first item.
Second item.
So, second item, check it. then the 100 quantity posted. If you want checking staff or you, it shows 1900 quantity. Understood. Sometimes it takes time to save in background and showing front end. Okay, you have to wait it, refresh it and see. Okay. Again, whether I can send good quality of goods. You can return with a very good quality of goods. Then you can post a GR. For receiving your goods, you have to use same your number and one around movement. Once the print your number here, the matter takes commissioner remaining 100 quantity. So yeah, only two movement of around 3, one person movement of around 1, you can put it here. Understood. These are all the, so many movement types are there. These are the regular with the movement types shown. Understood. Okay, I'm going to take class, okay, Shannon. So tomorrow we can discuss everything.